so good luck trying to break in. No one has ever tried, unless of course you count Goldfinger. The two-story tall fortress is surrounded by an electric perimeter fence, and beneath the structure lies a basement that houses the gold vault. The secure vault holds half of the U.S. Treasury's gold reserves, valued at $291 billion. It's only accessible by a few officials, and no single person knows the entire combination. Even the president is denied access to the facility, and no U.S. leader has been inside since FDR. Here's a secret tour inside Fort Knox. Let's take a look at the exterior of Fort Knox before we venture inside. Officially known as the United States Bullion Depository, the impenetrable facility was built back in 1936 at the behest of President Franklin Delano Roosevelt. The U.S. gold reserves were previously held in New York City and vulnerable to attack from foreign military powers. Fort Knox, which is 1,000 miles inland and to the west of the Appalachian Mountains, is packed full of security features and weaponry. As we pan around the exterior, you'll notice Fort Knox's gray facade. That's 4,200 cubic yards of concrete and 16,000 cubic feet of granite, over 750 tons of reinforced steel, and 670 tons of structural steel. Building such a menacing fortress wasn't cheap. The building materials cost the U.S. government $431,167, which equals about $8.02 million when adjusted for inflation. The cost of the entire project was $560,000, which is about $9.3 million adjusted for inflation. See these fences around Fort Knox? There are actually two separate electric fences around the depository. Around those two fences lies yet another concrete barrier, which acts as an additional defense measure. There's no way a vehicle could plow through the fences because of this barrier. Fencing surrounds the entirety of the facility, and if you look closely, you'll notice searchlights just past the innermost perimeter fence. As you drive along the entryway, you'll pass the barrier and first fence. The inner fence is protected by two guard stations on each side of the entryway. Show your credentials to the U.S. Mint Police guarding the entrance. Everything has to be in order. U.S. Mint Police can make upwards of $70,000 a year, and there can be as many as 50 guards on the base at any time. The entire security detail costs the government $4 to $5 million per year. Let's drive up to the fortress and take a closer look at the exterior security measures. Motion detectors and cameras are strategically placed around the exterior, so be aware that you're being watched. Take a look up and to the left. On the second level, you'll notice a guard tower being manned by officers with machine guns. There's a tower at the back, too, as well as one atop the second story. The area is being surveilled by ground-sweeping radar, and the lawn is littered with landmines. Yeah, I said landmines, so watch your step. At the back of the building, you'll find two large garage doors. This is where the $200,000 armored trucks unload the precious cargo. Have your credentials ready, because we're about to head inside. As the 22-ton front blast door opens, you'll be directed towards a security check where guards will pat you down and make sure your credentials are in order. Keep your pass on you at all times, because this is only the first checkpoint you'll have to clear. Every inch of Fort Knox's interior is covered in cameras and motion detectors. Follow the hallway down to the authentication room where officials weigh and inspect the gold. They make sure everything is real before the gold heads down to the basement vault. The authentication room connects directly to the garage where the gold is unloaded. It's actually incredibly rare for new gold to be added to the depository. In fact, no gold has been transferred to or from Fort Knox for many years. Let's take the hallway down to one of the service elevators. These are wide enough to carry pallets of gold down to the basement. As you exit the elevator, you'll be greeted by a security team who will once again check your credentials. After a pat-down, you can head down the hall to the vault where all the bullion is stored. The hallways in the basement are lined with cameras and motion detectors too. The gold vault door before your eyes is just as impenetrable as the depository's front door. It's also 22 tons and is 21 inches thick. Nothing can get through. Not explosives nor machine guns. Put them away. Even a flamethrower won't do any good. The door will laugh at you if you try. To get through the door, you'd need the combination, but no single person in the world knows the entire code. Once officials enter all parts of the combination, we can head inside the vault. As you look around, you'll see rows and rows of gold bars. Inside the vault lies 147.3 million ounces of gold, worth a book value of about $6.2 billion. Because the price of gold has skyrocketed over the last few decades, the stash is now worth $291 billion. At the end of the vault is a hidden door. This door leads to a secret escape tunnel with access to the main level of Fort Knox. It can only be accessed from the inside vault. Let's head up to the top level. The top level of Fort Knox is the command area. This is where the U.S. Mint Police survey the grounds. The communication center connects the guards to all areas of the depository, and the bulletproof glass windows on this level are all covered in steel bars. The guards have easy access to the balcony and outer guard towers via a secure door. This level is a huge armory filled with ammunition and guns. Did you know that during World War II, the Magna Carta was stored at Fort Knox? The historic document, which is worth about $15 million, briefly moved here during the Blitz. Thanks for watching.